The Prime Minister is under pressure tonight over his comments condemning the actions of the Chinese military in an accident which saw an Australian Navy diver injured. While Anthony Albanese refused to confirm whether he raised the issue directly with President Xi Jinping, China has told Australia to stop stirring up trouble.
After a busy few weeks trying to improve relations with China, Anthony Albanese's critics are asking if he's all handshakes, but no hard line.
We've got obviously a Prime Minister that doesn't know when and how to stand up for Australia's national interests.
It follows the incident a week ago where an Australian Navy diver was injured from sonar pulses from a Chinese warship. The Australian PM refusing to confirm whether he personally raised it with President Xi Jinping over the weekend at APEC in San Francisco.
I don't talk about private meetings on the sidelines, discussions I have with any world leader. That's how you keep communications open.
But it's open communication the opposition leader is calling for.
Did he raise the issue or he didn't? Just be open and honest with the Australian public. If he didn't, then he's made a catastrophic mistake and he needs to apologise for it.
While it's murky waters on who raised what and when, it's clear this condemnation.
This was dangerous, it was unsafe and unprofessional.
It hasn't been well received. From the Chinese Foreign Ministry, we hope the relevant party will stop stirring up trouble at China's doorstep and work with us to jointly sustain the momentum of the improvement and development of China-Australia relations. But that spin hasn't swayed the Defence Minister at trade and security talks in India.
For both of us, China is our biggest trade partner. For both of us, China is our biggest security anxiety.
A diplomatic knife's edge that's only getting sharper. Paris Martin for 10 News First.